Greetings, haulers. Welcome to the inaugural episode of Highball Haulers, the show of haulers, for haulers, by haulers, to paraphrase a quote. I'm Greyheart, prime organizer of the Nassau Trading Company. With the release of Star Citizen Alpha 3.0 in the near future, I thought it was time to create content specific to cargo haulers. While the majority of content will be aimed at multi-crew operations, you independent haulers may get some value as well. With the addition of the cargo hauling mechanic in 3.0, also comes the addition of the pirate mechanic. So, for this first episode, I wanted to talk about the new implied game mechanic of crew. Your crew is your first and only line of defense against piracy. If you're single manning a freelancer, cutlass, or even a connie, you will be at a distinct disadvantage should you come under attack. Those ships all have turrets for a reason. They allow the pilot or captain to make a beeline for your destination while still firing at those who want to take your cargo. If you have a ship with more than one seat, you need crew. Not just any crew, you need regular crew. These are people you fly with on a regular, if not constant, basis. This isn't just a matter of trust that the people you're flying with won't shoot you in the back of the head the first chance they get. It's a matter of survival. Your crew needs to know where to go and what they need to do the second you come under attack. In a freelancer or cutlass, flying with a partner, the choice is obvious. Whoever is not piloting runs to the turret and starts shooting. Of course, both of those ships have more than two seats available. You can have a pilot, a turret gunner, an engineer, and others. Who will do what when you come under attack? If your crew doesn't know, your chances of surviving, let alone retaining your ship and your cargo, drop significantly. Your crew needs to not only know where to go during an attack, but they need to be trained and become proficient at their battle station. A turret gunner who can't hit the broadside of a barn at 300 meters is useless. What about damage? You're a big target. If you find yourself in the middle of a fight, you're going to take damage. Which of your crew is going to stop what they're doing long enough to make repairs? Speaking of repairs, you have replacement parts, right? You don't need to carry extra coolers or shield generators, but you'd better have the fuses that make them work. You'd also better have someone close by who knows how to replace them quickly and efficiently. The faster you can remove and replace, the faster you can get out of the battle. This is why if you're a lone hauler, you're at a disadvantage in a fight. Even if you've converted your turrets to AI, you can't fly and replace engine parts at the same time. Okay, so you've got a regular crew, and they know what they're supposed to do during both normal crews and in battle. How quickly can they get to their battle station from any part of the ship? This is mainly for the bigger ships. The Caterpillar, the Starfarer, the bigger hull series, those ships. Let's face it, you don't know when or even if you're going to be attacked. If you did, you'd avoid the battle altogether. The corridors in those ships can be confusing, even with all the markings they have. This can be a plus if you're boarded. We'll get to that in a minute, but first, crew readiness. How fast can your crew be ready for a fight? In a Starfarer, how fast can your dorsal turret gunner get from the forward airlock under the flight deck to their turret? In a Caterpillar, how fast can your turret gunners get from the crew area to the forward dorsal and aft ventral turrets? In a hull C or larger, how fast can your engineer get from their bunk down the pipe to the engine room? You don't know? You'd better find out. You spend a lot of time in the black between ports. You've got more than enough time to drill your crew. Not only does it take the panic factor out of general quarters, you've done it 1,000 times before. It also keeps your crew alert and busy. I'm not saying you should run constant drills. Drills should be based on how well your crew responds. The better the drill response, the less frequent they need to be. All captains aboard NTC ships run regular readiness drills. If it's a new crew or a seasoned crew on a new ship, they'll drill daily. Once the crew is comfortable with the layout of the ship and response times are down, they may only drill once a cruise. Many of the captains make a game out of it. They'll run individual members from different parts of the ship. With a crew that's been together a while, they'll let the crew pick starting points for each other. You know you've done something wrong when they start you in the head. The person with the fastest time will get some reward. Usually, that's being the pilot for the next drill. Of course, you should also run unannounced drills, and drills in the middle of the night. It's one thing to be fast when you know the drill is coming. It's quite another when you're rudely awakened by the klaxon. A good crew will be trained in secondary or even tertiary jobs. That means at least two people know how to do every job aboard your ship. That includes captain. Having those extra skill sets can save your ship or your lives. Where should your crew be if you're boarded? You're unlikely to get boarded unless your engines are out. That means you've probably got wounded or dead crew. How do you plan to hold your crew, your ship, and your cargo? In that order. Know the choke points aboard your ship. Where can one or two crew hold off a much larger boarding force? On a Starfarer, that's going to be the catwalk above the cargo bay, and the top of the stairs just off the cargo bay. On a Cat, that's going to be the cross corridor behind the crew area. On a Constellation, that's going to be the walkway around the cargo bay, fore and aft. Where can you set up a crossfire to best effect? Who are your best shooters, and where are you going to place them? How fast can they get from their battle station to their boarding point? Where are the boarding points on your ship, and who will cover them? Look at your ship and think to yourself, if I wanted the cargo on board, how would I get it? Once you know how to open up your ship, you'll have a good idea where to place defenders. Now, you may be thinking this is overkill. You just want to have fun and make a few credits hauling cargo. Hauling cargo in the Verse is serious business. You need a plan. I can assure you that the pirates have a plan. Crew drills may not be sexy or fun, but dying every time your ship gets attacked is certainly not fun. I'm not saying you're going to be attacked every time you leave port. Coming under attack should be the exception, not the rule. As captain, you have a responsibility to your crew, your ship, and your cargo, in that order. The way to protect your cargo is by protecting your ship. The way to protect your ship is by training your crew. Next week, we're going to look at the Consolidated Outland Pioneer. Is it a ship that can be used for hauling cargo? Until then, may your forward scanners be clear and your hold full. If you like the content in this video, be sure to like and subscribe. During the 3.0 release, I'll be training ship captains. If you're interested in being a captain or crew of one of our 30-odd ships, contact me on our Discord server. Links are in the description.